Today our first activity is at 4, so we are basically going to be free all day until late afternoon.
Right now, breakfast?
Yeah, right now we're waiting for the other guys to drain us and get out to breakfast.
And Matthew, how was that last night?
What do you mean last night? Yeah. Excuse me?
Yesterday. Tell us about yesterday. The environment.
Zurich is cool, man. I like it better than Berlin for some reason. We went to a festival yesterday with a lot of interesting people, some good food at a Chinese restaurant. We came back to the hotel
yesterday. I can't remember what happened. What was yesterday? Yesterday was Sunday, right? Yeah. It was fun. I think we went out, Tunja and I went out quite early to go spot a few nice places, and we stumbled upon the whole town, which probably was one of the best party streets I've seen in a while. So the whole stretch of like a long street was just street food, you know, live performances, music, you know, anything you say, it was really, really good. So we had Chinese, for dinner. Then I think I stopped at some, some Brazilian place. I had capoeira, a couple of them. Then the guys came, joined after dinner. We went to the outdoor party place, which was really, really cool. And I think I disappeared, but the guys had much fun after that. So I don't know what happened. That's my part of the story. That's the tale.
I don't take it from different angles. Before the event, we watched from the white walkers and none of that.
They want to explain the origin of white.
At the beginning of every season, they have like a 1 hour, 1.5 hour animated like series talking about the histories before. I have one to five. I was really interested.
He wrote like an entire wiki.
Yeah.
You can trace back 1,000 years.
That's why people always come up with their own fun theories.
Yeah, exactly.
This incest one that we all seem to
be ignoring. No incest, that's how the Targaryen family is. They don't meet outside, but the blood of a dragon cannot
meet outside. Yeah, but it's incest. It's technically
more than any other side.
You know like how we're all annoyed that Jamie and Cersei were sleeping together?
Who is annoyed?
I mean, I'm annoyed though. I'm upset that Jamie and Cersei
are sleeping
together.
But it's good. Daenerys was sleeping
together. We can go and start to order our brunch. So there are 2 things on the menu.
Thank you.
my name's Marc. I'm the CEO of this company here you're visiting. So this is the headquarters of Ringier. Ringier is a family-owned company. A bit older than a startup. I hear you are all entrepreneurs. So Ringier is 180 years old. 180 years. So that shows you that being a media company, having done newspapers and magazines and printing plants for 180 years, we are in the middle of transformation now. People read less newspapers and less magazines. I come in a second to what we did. You have to imagine we are a company with about 7,500 employees, and they were working in that sector, journalism on news on paper. And we had to do the whole transformation. And Robin, who is here with me, Robin is a member of the group executive board, and he runs all the marketplaces business for Ringier, plus he's the CEO of Ringier Africa. He will especially talk to you about our businesses in Africa, where we started 5 years ago, 5.5 years ago. So back to the group, just in two sentences, we invested close to $2 billion into digital businesses, mainly marketplaces or classified businesses in the verticals jobs, cars, and real estate, plus of course horizontal marketplaces. That's our main investment. Then of course we're trying to bring all these legacy brands, newspapers and magazines, into the digital world. That's our second ambition that we want to do. We did also do investments in e-commerce, also in radio, even sports rights. So you see quite a broad diversification, which was necessary to have less dependency on our legacy business, which again was newspapers and magazines. So that's the story about Ringier. Then there's a story that I initiated 2.5 years ago. It's called Digital Switzerland. Now the story behind that, and Nicola, who is in the blue shirt, he's the CEO of this initiative. Digital Switzerland, goal is to make Switzerland a leading digital hub in Europe. I think I hand over to Robin, and then we hand over to Nicola, and I'm happy to sit somewhere and then see the kind of short presentations of you guys. Thank you for being here.
Hi everybody, my name is Robin. Why is Ringier in Africa? Maybe Marc, you missed that point. Ringier, besides nowadays being a digital company and formerly a traditional publisher, etc., is also kind of an expert in emerging markets. It's at least what we are considering ourselves. We started more than, almost 30 years ago, so late 80s, early 90s, doing business in Central Eastern Europe as absolute first movers in countries like Czechoslovakia, Romania, Poland, etc. Early 90s, we went to Vietnam, China, but nobody went there. Not easy, but we succeeded in those countries. Over three decades, we learned how to do business in early stage markets. We learned what kind of attitude, vision, long-term strategy is needed. Also, we learned something about patience. We learned something about political hiccups, not only in Africa, but 20 years before in many, many other geographies. So we found, hey, Africa, obviously learning about the digital revolution taking place on the continent as well. We thought, hey, Africa, with our DNA, with us not necessarily being a financial investor, but being operators, being startups ourselves, being interested in operating in the long term, Africa could be a good place to deploy and start and bring also the technologies, the digital know-how that we built and acquired the last 10 years. So we started there 5-6 years ago. In a very entrepreneurial way, just building a network, learning about the local markets, observing the first 2 years. It was with very little investment, very little support from headquarters. It was just being there, looking around, learning.
Two or three things about Digital Switzerland. As Marc said, we have a good economy, but still it changed so quickly. we might be in 5 years not a good economy anymore and have a much higher unemployment rate. So I just show you two or three things, better free, and you keep them in mind, than too much and you won't. There are statistics, 80% of companies, Ringier's best example for that, and all big corporates also in Africa, will increase the digital revenues within 3 years. By the way, we only use statistics for 3 years. Because what's behind 3 years is the speed of change no one knows. So we don't speak about 10 years or 20 years or a generation or whatever, we speak about 3. And we're happy if we can know a bit what's going on in 3 years. So that's the first number. All companies will increase the digital revenue, so 80% of them. In 2020, 100 million people in the world will make e-commerce with augmented reality. Today, it's maybe close to zero. It's a game, you know, it's a toy, but we don't really buy. In 3 years, 100 million people. So it's a huge new market. And if you're not in there, you're out. And the last one, I'm surprised to be honest about the 50% because I think it should be 100. It's from Gartner, but half of the companies in the world will transform within 3 years in a digital company. I think it should be 100%. The one who is not doing that might be out. So just some numbers, and it's not about Switzerland, it's about the world.
This has been the best spot so far on this hour, and I'll explain why. I think the startup movement is becoming so somewhat misunderstood by a lot of people in this business as usual. But I think the way you've given your presentation, for me, is the reason why we do what we do at CCL. We think technology is about the future, not just today. And every society, every business needs to find ways to catch up on it. While Africa may not necessarily have a strong base to build technology, there are so many things that we can bring to the table. And that's the excitement for what we do. And that's why we're excited about all the entrepreneurs in the room as well. In our opinion, not only are they building businesses to make money, they're building businesses to contribute to the development of Africa, but I think also to the development of the world. Because as you said, innovation is no longer something that is unique to a certain country. You can find exciting spots in unlikely places. And so without further ado, I'll let these guys speak for the continent. As much as we're on this talk, our hope is that it can end up getting a lot of investors and partners excited about their businesses. But also my own hidden agenda, which I say once in a while, is that they can also inspire Europe as to what and where Africa is moving to. So thank you so much for hosting us, and I hope you enjoy the presentation.
It was great. I think everyone could showcase what they do, and it was pretty impressive, I believe. That's why maybe they get us a drink now.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mark,
for being here.
Thank you very much. Bye-bye. Yeah, all right.
Very good.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Bye, everybody.
Bye.
All right, then. Bye. Cheers,
Mark. It was a real pleasure. Good luck tomorrow and Google and enjoy.
This was a good woman.
Yeah, it was awesome. Really good.
It was a really good one. Three companies all together. The problem is how they're going to negotiate. Some of these don't have it.
Because you know what I mean.
Because in Africa, you know, there's a lot of, within the startup, there's a lot of bullshit. People who came to different startups, what to do. I don't know. I'm not going to tell you what to do. We're going to figure it out. But we're learning, so that's
why. Yeah, exactly. Yeah, we learn while
we're seeing. We're seeing the gaps. You guys are very strong.
Yeah, very strong. As in, amazingly strong.
It's been a massive, experience.
The cool stuff is that you guys are learning.
All the winters.
Most of them are learning Europe. New Europe.
And Europe
learning
too.
Not like the big Europe.
Exactly. That's the way it is.
I'm proud of this truth.
Me too.
Amadou, any thoughts about today and just the
the proceedings.
Yeah, man. Zurich really has something special. Although it's smaller, you know, it's a good. I think that some money would be, you know, we'll get some investments from here. Not us personally, I'm talking about the group. Presentation was sharp. I mean, like I say, we can compete with any European startups like this one. Take the pitching, you know, letting out the message. It's a good one. Looking forward to Paris, though. Zurich, I think Zurich's something to look about. It'll be a surprise.
Yeah? I think you said it all. So briefed up the message pretty properly, so looking forward to Paris. And we still need to pitch here though, so next pitch in Zurich and then we'll kill it in Paris.
Oh.